what is a dissertation, what is the role of a student, that is very important. You should know what is your role, what you should expect from a guide. Then what are the topics that you'll have to write in the dissertation? And a dissertation has some format. What is the format that has to be followed? And I'm sure you all had a lecture yesterday also, I suppose. Yes. So you all must be very clear. I suppose at least 40%, 50%, and hopefully I add more 20-30%. So you all will be very much clear now. So what is your understanding of a dissertation? What do you all understand? What is a dissertation? I want it to be an interactive session because otherwise all of us will sleep except me. So it's better we interact. What do you understand by a dissertation? Anyone? Any language? Any language means in your own words.
Like so explained yesterday, it's something which already exists and we are doing a research on.
Okay, what else? Anything else? Very good. What else? We are doing a research. Very good.
Deals with observation.
Deals with observation.
Addition or expansion.
Very good.
On the resources.
Right.
Or already the research that has been done. Or a reproving. So we have to write it in concise way.
Right.
What are we doing for that?
Anyone else?
Exploring.
Very right. What else?
Explanation.
What else? Fine, you all are very clear, bit clear at least. So basically what is a dissertation? As you said, review and all, this picture indicates that if you want a postgraduate degree, you have to finish your dissertation. And a dissertation, you have to review, as someone said here, you have to review many books. You have to go through many books. So only after that you will be able to write your dissertation. Now this is the definition as per the dictionary. Dissertation is a lengthy written treatment on a subject, especially a long paper, submitted as a requirement for a degree. For a degree, as I told you, is very important for a post-graduation degree. And it's a lengthy written treatment. Lengthy, the meaning of lengthy over here is in-depth. In-depth study. The lengthy doesn't mean 500 pages. Because we have seen dissertations of 500 pages also. So, the literally meaning of lengthy is taken. So, it means in-depth. Here the word lengthy means in-depth. What is it? A detail. Because as you all just said, we have to review. So it's a detailed study of a topic. Focus, practical and a logistic coverage of a subject which is based on certain preset guidelines. There are some guidelines on which you have to base your dissertation. And whatever you want to write in your dissertation will all be proved. You will have all scientific evidences. So hence it is a logistic, logical science it becomes. Whatever you write has evidence. Now what is this? The person who is going to write the dissertation has to behave like a CID inspector. Why? You have to investigate. Whatever is done so far on the topic, you are going to investigate it. And add on whatever you are going to come up with from your study. So, is a serious and a formal attempt by student to demonstrate their abilities. This dissertation writing depends upon the student's abilities. How much the student is ready or can put it. So it's their abilities to investigate, develop, synthesize and apply materials pertaining to a topic in the field of their interest. Whatever is available on that topic, how are you going to apply to it? On what basis are you going to conduct your study? So that is what is a dissertation. A written presentation on the subject which investigates the problem in detail and contributes to knowledge in that particular area. Now this is what a written presentation, and then you already have some matter on one topic. You are going to add to it. So hence it gives, you are going to contribute knowledge to that particular area. You are going to add on more. Your study is going to come up with something new, which you are going to add on to that. What is already known. This is to be kept something very important. It is not a piece of writing designed to reproduce information. That means it is not that you have to just reproduce what is given in the books. Available elsewhere, but something new and expressive of one's individual ability to analyze the data. After you do your study, you are going to come out with some data. How you are going to analyze that data? The analysis of that data is what you are going to write in your dissertation. A written documentation of the study carried out by the student on the topic, a piece of writing usually divided into chapters. As we go ahead, there are few chapters which have to be covered in your dissertation. You all must have listened to it yesterday. Aims and objectives, observations, discussion. So those chapters. So your dissertation is divided into various chapters. Is an individually devised piece of work by a student. It means it is all your own efforts that you're going to put, and you're going to design it, you're going to devise it. It's your own baby, we say na. It'll be your own creation. In-depth study of a particular subject, in-depth study of a particular topic which contributes new information and knowledge in the field. Same point again. Your in-depth study is going to bring out some new information and new knowledge in that field. Now what, why? We have seen so far, what is a dissertation? But why should we write a dissertation? As the picture very clearly is indicating, and we started, for a postgraduate degree, dissertation is compulsory. So for that we have to write a dissertation. It's an important component of higher education and forms an important part of any master level program. Till you don't submit a dissertation, you're not going to get your degree. And you're not allowed to give your exams also, till your dissertation is not sanctioned. So it is the most important component. So this is what you need to understand. This is what I need to register here. That has to be done. And how much ever you delay in submitting this, your exams will be delayed. That's what I said last time also. It is a compulsory requirement for any PG study, same point. It helps in developing one's intellectual skills. Now why? What will this dissertation writing help you? What it will develop in you? It will develop your intellectual skills by enabling one to work with concepts and information relevant to the subject. You have got some idea about a topic. How are you going to add into it? Your intellectual skills are going to take control over this topic. So that is what you are going to develop. The student is going to discover and examine the problem area. Now you have got a study, you have collected a topic. What is the problem area in that topic? What do you feel further research is to be done in that topic? That you are going to investigate, that you are going to examine. And it widens the dimension of the fact. There are certain facts that we know about a topic. Your study is going to add to it, more facts are going to be added to it. So try to understand how sincere efforts should be from your side. Because you are going to give something to the system. What is the utility of dissertation writing? Now what we have seen the importance, now how is it going to help you again? It is an exercise to train a PG student to plan, execute, evaluate, write and report a scientific project. After you write your dissertation, this is the first step. There are possibilities, you may develop such a good interest towards research. You may develop an interest that you may want to do further more research. Because this dissertation writing is an exercise. You know how you are going to plan if you want to do any research. How to make scientific reports, how to write. So there are chances that you may go up to some clinical research also. You may take up some other research program also. So this is a training. Your dissertation writing is a training for you. It provides one with an opportunity to work independently at length on any topic of interest. Whatever topic you decide, you have to work on your own. So as I said, it is your creation. So it gives you time to work independently. You won't have like what happens in college and all when we give your projects or some assignment, two or three people do it together. So if one doesn't do, other does, or three of you are doing it together. Here, every individual has to do one single topic. So it is you alone who has to take the responsibility and you have to do it. It will be you working independently on this topic. It helps to develop a scientific attitude in a student. As I told, a scientific approach. How do you have to approach to a topic with a scientific attitude that it cultivates in a student? Then it helps the student to develop an ability to think on the subject. You are going to think over it. When you have taken a topic, you have to think. How do I need to work on this topic? What more have I to add to it? It enhances the knowledge on the topic and adds up to the system. Generation of scientific data. Now when you are going to work on it, when you are at the end, after your study of 9 months, or because this course is for 12 months, so after your study of 9 months, at the conclusion, you are going to come up with something new. That is scientific data, as I told you, the scientific data, because you have got evidences. For whatever you are going to claim, you have got evidence. This is in my 9 month study, I have seen that.